And so this weed here is another one of our problematic weed. It's called horseweed. Some farmers call it marestail. Scientific name is Conducive canadensis. Very common weed. It grows. It can germinate in the late fall or the early spring, and really become a problem throughout the soybean growing season if we don't get it controlled prior to planting. As far as glyphosate resistant species, this is probably the one that is infesting more acres than any other current species. It was our first one discovered in 1996, and we've seen it just spread and take off since that time. Unfortunately, in this case, where you got all this horseweed or marestail that didn't get controlled, we're probably not going to control it from this point on. And this is a glyphosate-resistant marestail, and it's had several applications of glyphosate already. We didn't have a different mode of action in the tank, and so we didn't get control, and now you're going to live with that for the rest of the season. We often get this kind of branching and this type of bushy growth habit as a result of not killing it the first time, and so the plant kind of branches out from there, and we see that occurring in a number of these plants. You know, there's some tops, meristems here that were killed out or burned out, and then so we get this branching pattern. This is probably 3 or 4 weeks away from producing seed. And that is it's a unique plant in that the seed of this species is aerially dispersed. And so it is really, really, really lightweight. And they're basically attached to tufts of hair. And so when the seed heads come out and you have those tufts of hair, any wind whatsoever, and it gets dispersed in the wind. And that is probably played a pretty good role in why we've seen horseweed spread, and particularly glyphosate-resistant horseweed spread. And there's been some researchers in the eastern U.S. that have been able to catch horseweed seed up in the upper atmosphere layers. So this seed can really travel really long distances. And if it is resistant seed, then that's even more of a problem. So we could have avoided all this if we would have put a different mode of action in the tank with the glyphosate, 2,4-D, for example, dicamba. Safluphenacil is a kind of a newer active ingredient that is sold as any of the Kixor products like Sharpen. Those are the trade names of some of them. And so we really need to manage this weed as a prior to planting, before the soybeans ever emerge. Once the soybeans are up, our chances of success go down dramatically.
Herbicide-resistant weeds are currently impacting agriculture on an unprecedented scale. Each year, herbicide-resistant weed populations occur with increasing frequency in response to the selection pressure imposed on them by modern crop production techniques. In order to prevent this situation from degrading further, producers must have a change in their mindset of weed management. For the most part, weed management decisions are currently based on single-year economic thresholds. However, in order to stop the spread and progression of herbicide-resistant weed populations, producers must think longer term and diversify their weed management techniques. This includes considering all available chemical, cultural, mechanical weed control methods, with the ultimate goal of eliminating weed seeds from the soil seed bank. Because many current herbicides have the same mechanisms of action, producers must understand herbicide mechanism of action and frequently rotate to herbicides that have different mechanisms of action so that resistant weeds do not predominate our production systems. Ultimately, the focus must shift from a single to a multifaceted approach. This way, producers can not only improve their weed management, but they can also be an effective part of the effort to prevent the further spread of herbicide-resistant weeds.